Hello there, and welcome back. So, today I'm going to be talking about my updated ATRT and swamp speeders that I made. You already seen them before, but I updated them, so now they are much, much better and more solid. Okay, so first up here we have the ATRT, and I think it looks really nice now. I'll just give you a little turnaround of it. Yeah, so when I updated it, I tried to make it as accurate as I could, and it's much more sturdy now, even though the leg just broke there. But it's, like I said, it's much more sturdy now. Before, if I just like nudged this part a little bit, then the entire top half would fall off, but I found a way to make that way better, and it worked out really well. And the other thing that I changed up was the legs, so you can see right there, that's accurate on the real thing. It's like that in the universe, and also they're much more articulated now, so I'll just show you. They can go all the way out, and they're much more sturdy. If I tried to do this on the old one, it would like instantly break. But yeah, so there's sort of a running pose. Okay, so of course, right when I'm trying to show you how more solid it is, but then it breaks. So yeah, that's pretty sad, but it's much more solid than the other one still, even though it breaks. So yeah, and it can also get into the correct like parked position that was shown in the Umbara arc, where in the scene where in the trenches you can see the ATRTs are down like that so that the troopers have easy access to them. And I think that looks pretty cool, and I'm glad that I was able to incorporate that feature, because when I was initially constructing the model, that was one of the main things that I wanted to get in, but I didn't get it in the first version, so it's good that I got it in now. Okay, next up we have the Swamp Speeder, which was actually a pretty recent video, but now, as you can see, it's way more accurate, and I think it looks a lot better too. It does look pretty similar, but it's different enough that I decided to make this update. So the two main differences on it are that instead of like the hinge up here on the red part, it used to be like a hinge, but now I just kind of fit in the bricks there. Yeah, and then the other main change is that I have the engine now smaller, which is also more accurate and with better coloring. And I'm pretty sure that in the movies and stuff, it's not actually light bluish gray, it's more light. But, yeah, I think it looks pretty good. I'll give a turnaround again. This is actually one of my favorite mocks that I've made. And it's pretty nice. Okay, that is gonna be all for today, but before you go, I might make instructions for both of them, or tutorial videos or something, so let me know in the comments if you'd be interested about those, and I will see you later.